Nobody can do this of themselves. That's why even Jesus said, listen, you know, except your righteousness exceeds that of the Pharisees, you're never going to enter in. Meaning that the only thing that's going to exceed that, because they were in works and trying to do everything of themselves. And that's why he said, you know, listen, you know, one greater is coming, you know, and when he comes, you know, he's going to comfort you. He's going to teach you all things. So what is he talking? He was talking about the Holy Spirit. He was talking about the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, the fourth dimension, the one who helps us do these things on your own of yourself. Not only you cannot do it, you're not going to want to do it. Okay, and you won't even think to do it, but by the very presence and power of Holy Spirit, which is, that's what he's here for, to help us. He helps us in our infirmities, according to the scripture. He makes intercession. He does things that we cannot do. That's what's going to help you do that, because when you're in conflict and you're really, like I said, very heated, you know, conversations and things of that sort, it's going to take more than you wanting to do the right thing. It's going to take the power of the Holy Spirit. That's what's so good about him. That's what he's here for. And he will help you. All right? So that was number four. Number five, let's go to the fifth commandment of relationship. Number five, thou shalt keep thy vision. Oh, this is one of my favorite ones. Thou shalt keep thy vision. Do you know a person really, you don't get to know a person until you know what their vision is. Do you realize that? That when you don't understand their vision, you don't really understand the person. I know the world has taught us how, you know, socially, how to get to know somebody. That is so not so. You know, one of the wonderful things about, you know, Holy Spirit is that through him working in you is how people really get to know you, because they don't really know you without him. And with him, you begin to get the real essence of who a person really is. And a part of that is their vision. You really want to know what a person is about. You know, start talking to them about what is your vision? What do you see for your life? What do you see for yourself? You know, vision, it can be the same as a dream. What are your dream? What are your goals? These are things that people have not yet achieved, but they're really looking, you know, forward to it. So thou shalt keep thy vision. Don't ever let something or someone change or take away your vision. What is your God-given vision for your life? You should have one. That's a major question. If you don't know it, you should write it down. What is my vision? What did God give me, okay, in a vision for my life? Because he does, and he gives it to everyone. Okay, or do you even have one? If you don't, then before you be looking to try to hook up with someone, or you're going to try to, you know, save the world, all these things that we, you know, get these big ideas about, let God give you a vision. Let him show you what it is, your purpose. Because vision is your purpose of why you're even here in the earth. My favorite scripture, here it comes. You want to write it down. I've been doing it for years. Some of you have it already. I'm sure you know it by heart. 2 Corinthians chapter 12. 2 Corinthians chapter 12 and verse 1 says, doubtless I will come into visions and revelation of the Lord. Okay? It's so good, because if you don't have a vision, when I ask the question, what is your vision? And you say, what is my vision? Do I have a vision? It's okay, because you ask the Lord and he'll give you one. And it's always been there, but you've maybe never been challenged or asked the question, what is your vision? Do you have a vision? You know, so tonight, maybe this is the first time you've been hearing this. Well, this is a good time for you to say, Lord, what is my vision? I know what I'd like to do, or I have a passion for this. I really enjoy doing that, or I'm gifted in this area, and all those things are wonderful, but let's find out which one is why you're here in the earth, because that's what your vision is to be fulfilled. Every relationship must have a vision, okay, especially husband and wives. And when I say that, here we go, don't get too upset with me, because I know you, in so many ways,